So for the finances, Todd talked about getting people on committees, and right now I said, well, who's on the finance committee, Todd? He goes, well, Julie, it's just you and me. It's like, okay. So we could use another person or two. This doesn't have to be a huge committee because it's mostly about taking the financials that we get each quarter that he gets from an outside firm. They send them in. And I basically take all these spreadsheets of numbers and try and make it into a way that we can understand kind of what's important. You know, I'm sure you guys have seen financial reports from auditors before that are just page after page after page, and by the second or third page, you just kind of glaze over and say, okay, who cares? So I try to make it a little bit more interesting. I do feel like you have to kind of put some of the stuff out there. So this is kind of a busy slide that just simply shows on the cash basis where all their assets are, where they hold everything. Because it's a small group and there's not a lot of going through their budgets, you know, it's not a lot to take in and understand, but you're welcome to take a look at this later. I don't want to spend too much time on that one. And then the income through December 2019, this, just so you know, this was just a really, really good year, and you'll see that when we get to the end slides. But you have all the areas where, you know, Todd mentions is where we get all our money from, all the different pieces of the pie here, and you can kind of see it in a table format and compare it to the prior year. This one in particular is going to be going away. So that's one that's going to have to be replaced. And that's one of the things Todd said, we got to be careful about having too many eggs in one basket, because any little change can make a big impact on their overall budget. So then the expenses, similar that you see from year over year, there's not significant changes in it. Can you speak to this one, the global biodiversity census, why that one number went down in terms of the expense?
Global biodiversity census is at this point basically our partnership with the tropical botanical garden in China that Todd was talking about earlier. And I believe that was money that was provided by the Neil Wilson Foundation for Todd and Richard to go to China to visit XTBG in China. It's on the books, but it's basically passing money.
Okay, that makes sense. And the only other one I had asked Todd about was the program expense. Looked like it had gone up, but actually what's budgeted is a lot more than this, because that is really one of the primary goals of the group, is to have programs out there collecting. So they actually try to put more emphasis on that and use up more of what they had budgeted. Benefits will actually, there's one new benefit that's been added, and that's a small retirement plan, and that will be added for 2020, so you won't see that till then. But this is just normal year-over-year increases. All right, this is the slide I'd like to spend a little bit more time on, because when you see the income for the various events and products and things that we have, you think, oh, that's a lot of money, but then you have to take out the expenses. So really, to me, it's all about the net amount. What's the bottom line that you get from each of these? So for the Firefly event, you can see that the net increase, we go from $20,000 in 2018 up to, you know, $39,000 plus in 2019. That is absolutely huge. And if you think about, you know, what DLIA can offer people, it's these experiences, getting out in nature, doing things. These are things that we can own. When I think about the products, I think about Great Smoky Mountains Association. They're the ones who sell things, and that's the retail arm of, you know, supporting the parks. And we really, you know, we're going to get something from our t-shirts and stuff like that, but we shouldn't be in the business of doing retail, you know, going out and selling these things. Let them do it. But I don't know that we'll grow that a lot more unless we come up with like a really cool bumper sticker that everybody wants, and we can, you know, get a piece of that. But we're always going to do that through them. And the same thing with donations, which I don't have on here exactly because that's not as big, but the donations arm, I really think of Friends of the Smokies. They're the ones who go out and really get people to donate money to the park, you know, for all the projects there. So if you think about it, what's unique to us that we really don't, you know, kind of cross over too much with our partners, it's these events. This is where we can really make a difference. And then also contracts, which, you know, can come and go, but then also getting grants. So the grants will need to be added at some point too, if we can get more of those. I just picked some of the bigger ones here. Salamander Ball, you know, thanks to everybody who worked on this one to make that a very successful event. A big increase over last year. I mean, these are significant changes. for year over year. And I think this will be a fairly stable, I would guess, you know, part of it. And eventually the products will kind of level out. We might get more this next year with more of the calendars going out. I think we sold about 500 in that last quarter when they first came out. So we're expecting that to be something. But the fact that it's a perpetual calendar, which means you can use the same calendar year after year after year, well, that's good and bad, right? So once you have one, you don't need to buy another one the next year and re-up it. So I don't know. But it's still a great thing. I gave them out as Christmas gifts, and everybody liked it. The contracts, the same ad, that one is definitely going away. And TVA can be gone at any time. And Todd might talk about that one later. So that's one that we have to be a little bit concerned about. I think another way of looking at this is with the pie charts, and you can see from 2018 to 2019 the shift where now the events became a much bigger portion of the pie. Donations, like I said, this is kind of in competition with Friends of the Smokies, but we still want to work on donations, you know, board member donations, other people. When you go out to some of the events, you'll have that little credit card slide thing that people can drop in money right there. Is that what it's called? Dip jar? Dip jar, I like that. And then again, we might get something with products, maybe thinking about what else we could do besides the calendar and t-shirts, and then the contracts, and then of course the grants will come in here as well. But the mix has certainly changed year over year, and one of the things we'll talk about maybe this afternoon is kind of what the targets we think should be. Right now there's no set target of here's what we want our portfolio mix to be, but that's something that, you know, we really need to think about. And so if anybody's interested in the finance side, you know, we could use one or two more people on the finance committee to maybe kind of help us think through that. And then as we work throughout the year with the different committees, we can say, hey, we really want to increase this, or we really want to increase that, and say that's kind of getting us closer to our target. And whenever you have a target mix, if any of you have your own personal financial stuff going on, it's not exact. You say, okay, I want to target 25% here and 30% there. You kind of work your way there over time. It's not like, you know, you get there today or tomorrow. Then we had the budget versus actual, you know. So here's what they budgeted and here's what they actually spent. Yeah, there are places where I think things could be increased. I don't know if he's going for private foundations anymore. We still are looking for that? Okay. And this is 2019 budget. Any questions about last year's budget versus actual?
Yes, we definitely need more grants. We did receive 3 different grants this year that we haven't received the money for, but we will. So that will be reflected. We have, I want to say, 25 to 30,000 new grants that we received from 2 grants from Friends of the Smokies and 1 from the Tulaski Fund. So that will be reflected in next year's numbers. Definitely, I'm actively working to get it.
And then this is just the expense side of the same thing. And so overall, if you look from last year, or from what we budgeted last year to what we actually came, we came ahead. And I remember, so that's certainly worthy of all the efforts of this whole group and the staff. And I had this question for Todd, because, you know, I'm not a real finance person. I'm a math major and stats and stuff, but finances, you know, I just play with numbers. I asked him, I said, so what happens when a nonprofit makes a profit? Is that a problem? And he says, no, it's not. It basically, they've been trying to build a little bit of a nest egg to have a fund set aside for if, like, one of those contracts falls through, they're not going to have to completely shut down stuff. So you always want to have a little bit extra. This is really great, but it doesn't mean that we're going to get that kind of little extra nest egg every single year. So this is worthy of good applause, and thank you to everybody on the board and all the other volunteers and the staff that made this happen. I just love getting to this kind of point. You know, if you have a number in parentheses, it's a lot different, and we have a different discussion and all that. so that's good. Okay, this is the proposed 2020 budget. And what we showed here is what they had budgeted in 19, what they actually had accrued. Now, that did not get updated, that middle column for the year end. So that's the only thing is I didn't get this updated because we just talked about this recently. So anyway, what you'd look at is what has changed from 19 to 20 in terms of what they're budgeting. And let's see if we can pick out any of the big ones here, like fireflies. You know, we did better, so, you know, and a salamander ball, so we might as well budget, you know, a little bit more for that.
Firefly events, we have continued to raise the price every year. So it was 70 125 2 years ago, and then 150 last year, and this year it is 225. I'm not sure if we'll continue how far we'll continue that trend, but it does still continue to sell very well. We've already sold a third of the 150 slots that we have available for that event, spread over three nights. And so that will be a significant increase. Also, last year at the Firefly event, the owners of the private land that we do that event on, the Worships, allowed us to auction off the guest house that we hold the event in, a few weekends of that, to the highest bidders in kind of a blind auction. And we had a number of very high bidders, and they hosted the high bidder, the top three or four high bidders. And so we made, I think, an extra $13,000 just on that alone. I think the Salamander Ball, we plan to keep the prices pretty stable. The tickets are $75, and last year we did an early bird special of $60.
Those are lofty goals. Can you talk about sort of strategies to hit the goals this year?
I don't have a lot to say on that. Todd will probably talk more about that
in the board meeting.
Mm-hmm. Also, I think Todd would say aim high.
Sure.
Yeah. I think the expenses, is 257.
Yeah.
And Julie said we don't have parentheses.
No. Yeah. No, we don't want to have any parentheses. That's for sure. And knowing that we're going into this with, you know, a surplus of almost 30,000. So that kind of helps too. This one maybe is GSMA going to be here this afternoon?
I think Laura will be here.
Okay. Because she might talk more about what we might actually anticipate. We were just throwing out a number before the 39,000 for that. So that could be different as well. You know, like I said, there's only certain areas that they have control over to grow. You know, and certainly grants, contracts, you know, like I said, this one's going away. This one, Todd just mentioned that one might go away.
Yes, I think at the moment they do. Todd has just said that places like TVA tend to stick with something for a few years and then move on to something. So we're just trying to be cautiously optimistic about keeping that and not relying on that solely.
Yeah. Yeah, but to your point, this is something to think about. If this feels like it might be a little too aggressive for next year, you know, how are we going to get there, and just watching. So what will happen is each quarter we'll do an update. We'll get the financials back. We'll talk about where we are, and then we always have a comment column where I say, you know, to Todd, do you feel like this particular one is on target? You feel like we're going to really get the rest of this income for the rest of the year, or are these expenses still under control? And so we try and give an opinion each quarter as we go along after we get the actual financials for where the numbers are.